you on provoking the favor of God.
Oh, yes.
Can I tell you something?
Talk to me.
There are things that provoke heaven. Everybody is praying, but it's a prayer that gets divine attention. Everyone is serving God, but there are some things that provoke heaven. Today we will provoke heaven. Mention favor, I knew that God wanted me to preach this message. Because he didn't know anything I was going to preach about. But God is a faithful God. If you came here expecting miracle, you shall go with a miracle. Can I tell you something? The atmosphere, listen to me, of expectancy is the breeding ground for a miracle. Let me say that again. The atmosphere of expectancy is the breeding ground for a miracle. And so if you came there expecting God to do something for you, God will do what you expect Him to do in your life. Am I telling you something here? Because when I was praying today, I saw the heavens open. I saw the heavens open. There is an open heavens spiritual environment today. And everyone that came expecting God to do something in their life is going out with a miracle. But you must understand that before we can attract favor, we must provoke favor. But I want to explain to you in a very little while, in a short while, what favor means. Because believers use favor at random. But I want to explain to you what favor means. Favor, everyone say favor. Say favor. Favor means partiality. And when we are talking about the favor of God, we are talking about the partiality of God. Let me tell you something. Favor is not fair. Yes, sometimes you look at somebody and you look at your face. One time I was talking with a lady in Ghana and a car came to pass and there was another lady sitting at the front of the car and the lady said, "Your baby." Over another person. That's why I told you on Friday, God said, "Jacob I love, Esau I hated." You know, Jacob had favor with God. They say, "What you have not qualified for shall be given unto you." And there are people who have degrees, B-A-D-K-K-Y, T-T-Y, and on top of the makeup, get some favor upon your life. Because your vital statistics are be 30, 32, 28. It is the favor of God. And that's why Mary, the Bible says, found favor in the sight of God. There were many virgins in Jerusalem in those days, but God found a woman in Nazareth of Galilee because she was having favor. And that tells us that if you carry favor, it doesn't matter. They might not like your face, but they can't ignore you. But come on, somebody shout, yeah! Shout, yeah! And I was looking at the word again, and it means unfair today, I will deliver the keys into your house. Because if you have a key, you know, you can have many children, but there's one that touches your house. Because they know how to open the door of your house. Isn't it? That's what God will say. David is a man after my heart. A guy has a messy life. But he said, you're a man after my heart. Look at that. Solomon. In the first place, can I tell you something? Solomon's mother was somebody's wife. David killed her husband and slept with her and gave birth to Solomon. But David had a legitimate son called Adonijah. By right, he was supposed to ascend the throne and took the responsibility of the kingship. But God says, my favor is not fair. I decide to choose a man. Now, can I prophesy to you right now? God will show unfair partiality to somebody here today, not because of what you have done, but because of what he has done. That is what grace is all about. It's not what you have done, it's what he has done. But there are some things you can do to get his attention. Are you ready?
Yes.